Southwest Florida, welcome back. We're here at the famed Lee County Black History Museum. This is Williams Academy, which is the first and the only school in the area during before segregation that African Americans could attend in the whole region. So they came from all over to come to Williams Academy. Behind me is a replica of the classrooms, those chairs, late 1800s, early 1900s. This is where black people got educated coming out of Jim Crow segregation. All that's great for you to Google and come out here and tour this museum that's hosting Lee Pitts Live. What better place to bring my television show than to the Lee County Black History Museum? And if you haven't noticed, take a close look. Black. Having said all of that, we're so thrilled to get here. A person, if you take a look at her, same skin color, and she's doing an outstanding job. Not just a black for black, just like the TV show is not just for black. But when people see me, they can't help but say it's the black show. And as long as you're associating black with something positive, I'm fine with that. You want to call it the black show.
All right.
But when a white person is hosting a show who interviews a wide range of races, Michelle, just like I interview a wide range of races, they don't call it the white show.
Right, right.
But that's just America.
We got to reframe things. Yes, we do.
That's what I like about you in that position. You don't forget your community, and you bring that sensitivity to everything that you're doing. I let people know that at the last second, I said, Michelle, I'd really love to get you in here, and you cleared your schedule, and you made it in for this special, my start into the foray of documenting the recovery effort for Hurricane Ian. First of all, tell people, what is the City of Fort Myers Community Redevelopment Agency?
The City of Fort Myers Community Redevelopment Agency was created to serve the older parts of the city, the what we would call the underserved parts of the city, and our purpose is to increase the tax base. And in doing so, we're uplifting those communities, we're uplifting those neighborhoods, we're working with those citizens to do homeowner improvements to their properties, we're working with small businesses to support them so that they are successful. Because you know, Lee, we are all tied together and there's no separating us. We're one.
Just listening to that simple description of the City of Fort Myers Community Redevelopment Agency, now as we've gone through the atrocity of a once-in-a-lifetime hurricane, we are blessed that we have the machinery in place of a CRA in terms of the recovery process. What are some things that a CRA can do for the city in the recovery process?
And so let me start by saying that the CRA is an agency of the city. We are partners with the city and we enhance what the city does. We have special funding tools that allow us to do something a little different than the city. And so right now we are looking to working with assessing businesses so that we can determine their needs. You know, it's one thing for us to tell them what they need, and it's another thing for them to tell us what they need and for us to put together and implement programs that will fulfill those needs. So we are already on the ground. We're partnered with the River District Alliance, Executive Director Lisa Sputoni. She's already got folks out there. Dr. Melanie Long will be working with Executive Director Sputoni from the CRA side. We will not just be hitting downtown, but we will be hitting all the redevelopment areas. And that's downtown, that's Cleveland Avenue, and that's Martin Luther King area. And we will be going door to door, we will be doing email, we will be using all the tools available to us to get to people to understand what the needs are.
So the CRA in general has two prongs, housing and business. Is there another prong to you as well?
Commercial and residential.
Okay.
And largely we work in the commercial space, but we do have, as you've heard on our, when I've been on before, housing programs.
Right.
Because we know that affordable housing is a huge issue. And so we have programs that support creating new affordable housing as well as reinforcing the existing affordable housing. We also have a revolving loan program that is dedicated specifically to building affordable housing in our redevelopment areas.
Now, I know from my understanding of the CRA, largely you operate from tax increment dollars. Under this particular scenario with FEMA, disaster relief? Mm-hmm. Is there a way where some additional dollars may come into your office that can use to enhance the recovery process?
So we've already started having meetings, and we are looking to attract those dollars and those resources that can come to us or through us that goes to support the businesses and the residents of the redevelopment areas.
That is so beautiful, because that's what you guys do. Mm-hmm. Okay, so you don't have to reinvent the wheel.
The programs already exist.
That's right.
They're there.
Right. So let's You brought up downtown. Mm-hmm. And when we think about the city of Fort Myers, we do think about downtown, because when this hit, I know your office is downtown.
Yeah, my office is hopefully hit hard.
Right. So what is let's humanize this. Mm-hmm. Where were you when all of this happened?
So
when the hurricane landed?
I was at home. I had with me my mother and actually our new assistant director, Dr. Long, who both lived in Dean Park.
Looking forward to having her on the show in the future.
Yes, and she'll be here soon. And Dean Park was in the evacuation area. So they both left there and came and stayed with my husband and I. And, we weathered the storm well. However, when they returned home, both their places were underwater.
Really?
Dean Park took on a lot of water. There was 5 foot of standing water in their homes. Yeah.
And you were on a two-story building? You?
No,
were you
on a one-story? One-story building.
Mm-hmm. You just felt the shimmers, and you didn't get any flooding?
We didn't get any flooding, but it sounded like a freight train. Mm-hmm. I mean, we got the wind, and it just stayed on top of the house for like 4 or 5 hours. It just was beating us. Never stop.
And you think that this is stuff that happens to other people, right?
Oh, boy.
We've seen this on TV.
It's come home.
I think the governor said a once in a five-year type of a storm. 500 years.
I was going to say.
500
yeah.
years.
500, yeah.
Yeah, so.
Yeah, this is pretty devastating.
All right, now, walking around.
Yeah.
I really wanted to personalize this, because I want people to know that people like yourself, who are city officials, who are walking around our agency of the city trying to do things, you are human too. You experience things too. You didn't have some special thing like the president, big bunker with steel walls, anything like that.
Right,
so
right.
You're dealing with your own personal situation. Your office got flooded out. Mm-hmm. All of that, and you're trying to help somebody else. How are you balancing both?
And, that's what we do. And, this is fortunate or unfortunate for me. My personality is such that when there's stuff to do, I can put my feelings over here and just get to work. That doesn't work with everybody, because some people really are in their feelings. But, in a time like this, we have to come together. And I have to say this to the City of Fort Myers staff, that we've all been working together very closely, and they are doing an amazing job. The resources that have been brought to bear to support this community, to help clean up this community, to restore services, has just been incredible. And I just want a big shout out to all those that have come to aid and assist us as we're going through this recovery.
Now, if someone says, some people may say that, hey, our area has been neglected, Dunbar, East Fort Myers, I know Harlem Heights is not in the city of Fort Myers, correct?
It's south. Yeah.
Right. But we're being neglected, we're not getting the resources. What do you say to those people?
That's not what I'm seeing.
Okay.
I am seeing, I know that Fifth Third Bank is here providing a place for people to fill out their FEMA applications. I know that City of Fort Myers, their utility trucks are out clearing away. I know that we are coordinating with all the utility first responders to make sure that the place is safe, mm-hmm. and to get debris out of the way. And yes, we can't get to everybody at once. Mm-hmm. That's kind of the way it works. You've got limited resources, but that's not what I've seen.
Okay, and food and shelter?
Everywhere. Mount Harmon Church, Mount Olive Church, Next Level Church. We have this community that has come together in a way that I've never seen before. We always work together, but this unison that has come out of this is incredible.
And I haven't, and I don't know if you can speak to this, or you may have, and I'll talk to the chief of police soon, but vandalism doesn't seem to be running rampant. I haven't heard anything about vandalism in the city.
I think there was one incident the night of Mm-hmm. And, you know, the police department, they've been out in full force. They've got support from agencies around the state, utility around the state. That's not an issue. People are working together, and it's inspiring to see.
It looks like some people are getting more food now than they hot food.
I tell you what, because every day,
I mean, I'm looking at all these hot food. I'm like, man, I couldn't get gumbo, everything, fish, shrimp.
Yeah, people are being fed now, but what we want to make sure is that beyond that, they have the resources and the tools to rebuild. Mm-hmm. And so those resources are being brought in as well.
I want people to know also that you and I are having this conversation on October the 7th. So if people who are looking at this, this is October the 7th. At October the 7th, there's still an issue with the water, and I know a lot of electricity has been turned on. Where do we stand on the water, to your knowledge?
So I know that I can't speak for the city. I know the city is making great efforts. They're kind of phasing in the water. And so I think water will be restored to everyone very soon. A lot of that is also based on the return of the power supply. And so I see it coming soon, but that's all I can say. I can't speak for the
right.
city.
That's fine. How do you see the city functioning right now? Ian is the high priority. Ian has just come in and kind of paralyzed things. But is the city running, like, say, the budget's approved, the normal city functions? You see the city is going to continue to operate as normal?
Yes, it will. Yes, it will. The leadership has got it down. And so we are dealing with the hurricane on the one side. But the day-to-day operations of the city, while all the departments may not be up and running functionally, we will bring forward those things that are needed to help people get back to some sense of normalcy.
I'm going to be talking to the city manager, Martin Lawing.
Lawing, yes.
And along with the mayor of the city of Fort Myers, Kevin Anderson. Mm-hmm.
Who's also the chairman of the CRA, by the way.
The chief of the fire department, MacMillan, and the acting chief of the police department, mm-hmm. Pepitone. All of them will be working their way through here. Mm-hmm. And you've gotten a chance to work closely with them as well, as well as the other city council people in this whole process. What's your overall assessment of these professionals and how they're carrying out their functions?
Well, I have to tell you that this team is one team and has come together in a way. Again, I've worked hurricanes before, like from the shelter side. This is the first time I've been a part of the leadership team. And everything is working very smoothly. There is a central location where we meet daily, sometimes twice a day in the beginning, and everyone is reporting in and doing their part and coordinating. I think it's going famously.
Off air, over the days in the past, I've had conversations with our mayor. He was saying, Lee, I want you to make sure that you know that I've been going out to all the communities. Communities that may feel that they're being neglected. Mm-hmm. I am concerned about all the communities mm-hmm. and make sure that they know mm-hmm. as a mayor, I want everybody to get the opportunity to come back strong. Your thoughts on the mayor?
I tell you, Mayor Anderson, Chairman Anderson, he works across the city. I can tell you that for sure. I've said to him on many occasions, you are really there showing up everywhere for our community. Mm-hmm. And that is consistent in this situation as well.
You mentioned early on, I think you mentioned Fifth Third Bank, and I think you may have had a meeting with Heights, I think it's Truist.
Truist.
Right. So banks can play a role. Our financial institutions can play a role in this revitalization process. Tell me some ways that they can be involved as well.
So they are very interested in supporting the community. They're a part of our community. They're here. And so they're looking at the programs we have to see if they can also augment our funding so that we can assist more people. Fifth Third Bank, I said, Esther Marshall's team and the SBDC working together brought the e-bus to the Enterprise Center. It is there now all day today for people who need a place to go and fill out those FEMA applications, to fill out their insurance claims. So yes, the banks, everyone in the community, truly, the businesses, mm-hmm. the businesses downtown, they're having drop sites, they're providing food for people. Now, a lot of the restaurants haven't come back, but we've had businesses even come from Naples, set up on the street, providing hot meals for our community.
Mm-hmm. I'm glad you talked about the e-bus and the whole FEMA process. Mm-hmm. T- technical assistance is going to be needed for a lot of people, elderly people, people who they might go, oh, all this paperwork, all this. That. So we as a city are putting places, things, easy access for people to apply for these various funds. That's the way you're seeing it?
That's the way I've seen it. And I think we're going to have to do a whole lot more of that as this goes on, because it's not going to happen overnight and or quickly. But yes, providing those resources, making providing access to people so that they can get these applications in and kind of walk them through the process, that's something that's very needed. And I see the CRA playing a role in that.
Where would you recommend that people go? Is there a website? Should they go to the city's website?
The City of Fort Myers website, set up special pages to deal with the hurricane. They should go there first. They can also go to the county website. But between the City of Fort Myers and Lee County and all that's pushed out on social media, they are going to be able to find the information they need. We're appreciative of you that you're going to put it on the radio. Mm-hmm. Some people don't have access to the internet yet. Some people don't have telephone. A lot of people have radio.
So. And TV.
And TV.
TV and social media.
TV and social media and radio,
Now, I've been trying to figure out how to say this in a way that people won't find me to be insensitive about things, but optimistic in the vein. When you have this type of what we have here, and you have a lot of government dollars coming in here, a lot of things that are going to be repaired is going to actually upgrade. Those will be upgrades. We'll have better roofing, better landscaping, better infrastructure, better modern traffic lights. The system in some way will benefit from that as well.
Yes.
Can you talk about that as a redevelopment type person?
So, you know, this hurricane is a huge setback, but it's also a setup for a great comeback, because those dollars are coming in and we will be able to upgrade our infrastructure, upgrade the public amenities that have been damaged, destroyed, and provide assistance for our businesses as well as our homeowners. So, yes, there is. This is a setback, but it's setting us up for a great comeback.
Right. And then lessons learned in terms of the surge of water,
you know,
the
oh
way
my gosh.
We rebuild. Like I think they did that in New Orleans where they built a big wall or something like that.
So hurricane. We have a project that's going in downtown right now in the corner of First and Fowler, and they are building that based on the new FEMA maps, which required at least 6 feet up before the first floor. And so that is happening right now. And you will see more of that based on the maps, based on this event.
And I was talking to some people at the Luminary Hotel that experienced very little damage because it's built
They're also built up.
That's a modern structure that already came in with those types of things.
Exactly.
And now new permits that are drawn, you're starting to reap change how permitting is done?
Well, we'll have to adjust according to after this experience and taking away the lessons for future events that are going to come, you know.
Okay.
So, yeah.
Any final points? Take a look into that camera right there.
So I just want to say to the region, to the City of Fort Myers, to Lee County, that we are coming back. We are coming back better than before. Stay strong. We're one.
Okay, you heard it right here from our leader, the executive director of the City of Fort Myers Community Redevelopment Agency, Michelle Hilton Terry. Michelle, is it still cool to say Miami may have the oranges, but Fort Myers still got
the juice.
We still got the juice.
Yes.
We'll see you.
Lee Pitts Live is a Lee Pitts Enterprise production.
Hello, everybody. This is Lee. I'm so glad that you watched that particular show. And if you enjoyed that show, we got other shows like that. Just subscribe to our YouTube channel. Watch Lee Pitts Live on demand anytime. And also hit us up on all our social media platforms. Just type in Lee Pitts Live, and there you go.